Welcome everybody to the very first pitch night here at the fantastic Queensland Startup Precinct. We are very fortunate to be able to get this date. We went back and forth a little bit, but we got it in the end. So thank you very much to the city for making this space available. It will be an awesome space for many, many functions, events and pitch nights to come, no doubt. One of the things we do first here, of course, is to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land in which we're gathering here tonight, and certainly pay our respects to elders past and present. There's a range of folk who I'd like to welcome here tonight, not individually, but just as groups. First of all, delighted to welcome all of you who are founders of companies or are would-be founders of companies. This is why we do these things, these types of events, this type of precinct, the types of people who are here tonight are all here to help you succeed, help you understand what it is to make a startup business, help you understand what it is to create value in an ever-changing world. So welcome to all of you who are challenging yourselves to be founders or challenging yourselves to learn how to be founders. Thank you to all of you who are here tonight to give your time, efforts and money to these young folk who are really out there trying to change the world. This is an important piece of making anything successful in this space as an ecosystem, so I know that there's a tremendous number of you here who spend a lot of your hours helping, mentoring, networking and connecting our young founders here in Queensland. So thank you very much. Thank you to the supporters who are going, who have come here to support our Germinate 9 founders as well. Thank you for coming on. I'd also like to especially thank representatives from the university who are here tonight, who I know are incredibly passionate about how we are positioning UQ, UQ students, UQ's researchers to really be positioned, not just to take on, but to absolutely lead in what is an ever-changing world as we go forward. So welcome to you. I'd also welcome Nimrod Clayman, who's my colleague, who runs Idea Network. If you have any questions about Idea Network, you'll be able to talk with Nimrod. Is Andrew Walker here? No, he didn't make it. So Andrew's the president of the UQ Innovation Entrepreneurship Society. We're doing a fantastic job as students as well. All right, just a quick run through of our agenda tonight. So I'll welcome up Ian shortly to welcome you here and give you a few words about what UQ is doing in the entrepreneurship and innovation space. Rose is going to talk a little bit about this awesome precinct as well, to give you a bit more background about what they're doing with it and how you can interact with it. I'm going to talk to you quickly about our important feedback app that's going to help you give feedback to these guys on their business in a really, hopefully, a kind of effective way. Then we're going to pitch into our round two. Have a break in the middle. After it'll be 5 to 10 minutes. It's not a long break. It's just a necessary break. I'll give you a few closing remarks and some updates on what we're doing at iLab, and then we'll have some more refreshments and join our founders on their tables to talk to them more explicitly about their business. All right. With that, let me welcome Professor Ian Watson. You all have your programs, of course. On the programs we've listed, if you're doing social media, some of the hashtags that would be useful to us as well. So have a look at that, and by all means, please tweet Facebook or Instagram your experience tonight. Thank you very much for those of you who helped us with that. With that, let me welcome Professor Ian Watson, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of External Engagement here at the University of Queensland.
There's a risk. It's the eve of St. Patrick's Day. We've got a marriage guy who's an academic with a microphone in front of an audience. I promise I won't eat up too much of your time. You're not here to listen to me. But it would be completely remiss of not taking this opportunity to highlight the emphasis and highlight the importance and also highlight the commitment of UQ to iLab, Ideas Hub, also innovation and entrepreneurship and creation of knowledge and value addition, not only to Brisbane and not only to Queensland, but also globally. We've actually been in that business for 100 years. What we haven't done is we haven't told the stories very well. So one of the great things about tonight is actually And great things about being in this city, as opposed to being at St. Lucia, we've become much more visible to a whole host of people that we can actually talk to. The commitment at UQ is not only to iLab, it's not only to Ideas Hub, it's to a huge student strategy which is based fundamentally on engaging the students, but entrepreneurship and innovation as an ethos is something that is fundamental to that strategy. So we're investing a significant amount of money in that, and we hope that the students not only may progress through Ideas Hub to iLab, other great things, but also may actually end up in government, may end up in hospitals, may end up in the public sector, being innovative and creative as well. This is a little bit like full circle for me. I wasn't always an academic. I used to work for Goldman Sachs many years ago. And one of the things I was tasked to do as a young associate was to value dot-coms. Dot-coms were things like Yahoo, things like, what else did we have at that point? Now we had Google, obviously, but Yahoo was the interesting one because you had a price-to-earnings ratio of 1,050:1. And any of you knowing about PE ratios, you'll realize that's pretty high. Well, you don't even know PE ratios, you just didn't know that's a high number. And I was tasked to say, well, how do you value these things? Because the first thing that tells you is that valuation doesn't work. And we did many things and many interesting things. Look at the price per engineer. Look at the price per employee. What we ended up fundamentally doing was saying, we have no clue how to value these things. None. And what we do is we take a bet on a whole host of things in a whole host of different industries. And the beauty of Idealab is that it narrows down our bet because you have to succeed to get through these filters. And tonight is a pitch, and I hopefully will be able to stay for most of it. But I look forward to hearing what's on offer tonight, and hearing what value is going to be added, and hopefully, as a filter, looking at how we're going to progress that. So again, on behalf of UQ, on behalf of Peter Roy, who unfortunately can't be here, and my colleagues who are here, I hope you enjoy tonight, I hope you get a lot out of it, and just remember, the University of Queensland is going to be in this proximity for a long time. It's going to be in this space for another 100 years, and we want you part of it. Thank you.
Ian, thank you very much for that. We are in a fantastic space. Some of you have probably had a bit of a walk around, some of you are probably living here, which is nice for you, and some of you are probably going to move in here pretty soon. But it is a fantastic space. It's taken a lot of work, a lot of effort, a lot of conversations, a lot of tears to actually bring this place into being. And with that, I would absolutely, I'm delighted to bring to the stage Rosie Hobsey, who's going to talk a few minutes about the Queensland Startup Precinct.
Well, hello and welcome to the Startup Precinct. I'm happy to say this is officially the largest event we've ever had.
Awesome.
Yeah, no, thank you guys for coming down, and I'm really glad to see so many people engaged in the startup community. This space was started so that we could bring startups, investors, different bodies, universities, all of the groups that we possibly can, championing the startup effort in Queensland together. And I think it's doing pretty well so far. For those of you who don't know about this space, this is a Queensland government initiative run under the Department of Science, IT and Innovation. We've got quite a few tenants coming in, the key of which would be River City Labs moving in at the top. And we've got smaller tenancies as well, all part of this ecosystem as well as us. So if you're interested in taking a look around, and I'm sure some of you have tried, and I apologise for locking your doors, then after the pitches finish off, I'll be waiting around in the registration tables, and I'm happy to take some of you around. Just a final word on what's happening tonight. I spent a lot of time as a student, probably too long, and it's programs like these that really do make the difference. So thank you for really supporting it, and I hope you enjoy your time at the Startup Precinct.
Thank you very much. Before we get on to the pitches, one of the things we're about to do is give the team some feedback on those pitches. That means we have the ILAB app, the ILAB feedback app. It's actually just a Google form, but that's what MVPs are all about. So if you look on your program, you will get to find yourself instructions on how to do this, but essentially it's quite easy. On a website, type in bit.ly/ILAB, and importantly, capital UQG9, and that should then bring you up into a form that looks like that on the left. A couple of quick important notes about when you do fill in the form. Make sure you do choose the team, because you choose that team correctly, because that's the way we know what the feedback goes to. We do ask you if you actually have experience in this space, or if you're new to this space, which maybe gives us a little bit more insight into where you're coming from with your feedback. It's pretty straightforward. If you can't follow that, I'm not sure if your feedback is absolutely worthwhile. Okay. One thing I would like to point out, we asked two questions. Would you invest in the team? And then would you invest in this startup? So just note that there's a slight difference there, because obviously, importantly, a team is such a critical component. We would like to have that differentiated. Lastly, we do this anonymously, unless you don't want it to be anonymous. So if you're happy for that startup team to contact you, if you are interested in talking more with them outside of this forum, if you have connections for them that you think that would be worthwhile to make and you'd like them to email you, then can you please put your contact details at the end of the form as well. It probably takes about 30 seconds to do, which is easy to do in the Q&A time and the transition time. So if you guys can do that, that works really well. We did it before with our mini accelerator 6 months ago, and the feedback was very well received. So thank you very much if you can do that. Okay, we're into the pitches.